Hey, welcome to the Beer Masters Wonder Falls episode 8, Lovesick Ass. My name is Eric.
My name is Joe.
Hello, Joe.
Hello, Eric.
We're in a great place right now.
It's November 9th.
Yes, it is.
And we are both in an excellent place right now.
Absolutely. Not only has the presidential election totally worked out the way we thought it would.
Yep. It went exactly the way that everyone hoped that it would.
Yep. Not only that, I'm totally not dealing with some weird personal shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, we are not doing great.
Yeah. No. No.
But luckily, we have this episode of Wonder Falls to totally rub it in our faces.
It's only rubbing it in one of our faces.
That is true.
If we're being honest.
That is also very true. Yeah.
Though I did have some problems with one of the characters in this episode and his rampant misogyny. That's right, everyone. President-elect Trump appears in this episode in the form of a 12-year-old boy named Peter Johnson.
Yep. Oh, we got through this.
Through the
episode?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was fine.
It was totally fine.
Yeah, this one I completely did not remember at all.
Really?
From when I watched the show before.
Right.
And it's easy to see why. Because this one's not great.
It's not.
Yeah.
Despite everything else that we've alluded to here, yeah, it's just not particularly noteworthy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's, the show is trying really hard to make Jay and Eric a thing.
Yep.
And it's just not, I mean, Eric has no personality.
None whatsoever.
At all.
He is a brick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so,
just, like his namesake.
Yeah. Eric Estrada?
Yep.
Eric Roberts?
Yep.
Eric LaSalle? No, Eric LaSalle is not a brick.
I'm not too sure about Eric LaSalle.
No?
Yeah. I can't actually recall anything I've memorably seen him in.
ER?
I know he's been in the ER.
Okay.
I'm not a fan of ER.
Oh, well. Agree to disagree.
It's fine. It's just, that show went on way too long.
Oh, yeah, it definitely did. Yeah. 10 seasons too long, probably.
Yeah. I remember, I never really watched that show,
mm-hmm.
but there was an episode where the bad guy from RoboCop, bald guy in RoboCop, he's the guy that gets dumped with toxic sludge.
Okay.
And then gets run over by a van.
And not Red Foreman?
Not Red Foreman.
Okay.
Yeah, the bald guy. He was like the chief of medicine on
ER. Oh, that's right. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
The one episode of ER that I pretty much ever watched was the one where a fucking helicopter falls on him.
Yeah.
And he dies.
That
and
was...
nobody knows.
That was ironic. Because his arm had been cut off by a helicopter blade.
Yes.
I did not see that episode. I had stopped watching the show long before that happened. But yeah, that was a cartoon.
Yep.
He's Wile E. Coyote in that moment.
And yet, the only episode of ER that I ever watched.
That's impressive.
Yeah.
That's the only one that you've seen. Cause there are, hundreds of other episodes that you could have watched.
I'm aware.
And absolutely should watch before watching that one.
I believe that I was working at the TV station at the time, and it just happened to be on a night that I was working.
That's an excellent random episode to see.
Yep.
And by excellent, I mean terrible.
Kind of like this episode of Wonderfalls.
Kind of.
It's not super terrible.
Yeah.
There are moments.
Yeah. It's problematic.
Sure.
I would say.
But after 8 episodes, you know, 1 week one is not too bad of a track record.
Yeah, no, yeah. It's not bad at all.
But yeah, this one is not great.
It's just, it's really thin.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But, I mean, that's the main thing, and it's sort of, again, it's just trying really hard with Jay and Eric.
Yeah.
And like, her parents aren't in it at all.
Nope.
And Aaron's not in it at all. The animals are barely in it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, this episode could have functioned without the divine or otherwise voices from the animals, and it would have been completely unchanged.
Yeah, pretty much.
So, yeah, that's not, you know, not a great start for an episode.
Nope. I mean, maybe they were trying for something different.
Maybe, but... I guess.
Man, it did not work.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Certainly. we start, I don't know, I don't even really want to talk about it in a ton of detail. So Eric is trying to ingratiate himself to Jay, I think. I don't know.
I guess.
Who knows?
Yeah.
What is happening? But he's installing a satellite dish for her while she and Mahandra watch and admire the man meat.
Sure.
Because apparently Eric is a beefcake.
I guess. I mean, he's, I guess, averagely handsome?
Yeah, he's a fine-looking gentleman.
Sure.
With maybe slightly above average body?
Sure.
I would say.
I mean, I've definitely found other males more attractive than I have found Eric on this show.
Yeah.
He's just, you know, sort of generically handsome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I guess, you know, it's slim pickings in Niagara Falls.
Sure. Mostly tourists, I guess. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And slim pickings.
Well,
literally.
Yep.
Yeah.
What we have here is a failure to communicate.
Exactly. Exactly. You get it. So that happens, and really serves no purpose in the episode at all, now that I think about it. Because the episode really starts when we meet Katya.
I believe that's her name. Yeah,
And she is a Russian mail order bride.
Yep,
who has come to Niagara because she met a man online, and they are going to be married.
Sure. And this is where things take an uncomfortable turn for me.
Yeah. Yeah. Because of the numerous times that you've ordered mail-order brides from Russia?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And let's also not forget the fact that I work in a building that has a Russian bride service in the downstairs floor from where I work.
Seriously?
Yes.
I had no idea.
Yes.
Wow.
Uh-huh.
Yikes.
So about, I'd say every 2 months, there is a new influx of just Russian women usually hanging out front smoking.
Wow.
As part of a cleaning service.
Okay.
Who then also eventually disappear and get replaced by other Russian women.
Yikes.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Yep. This is a thing that has happened regularly.
That's...
for the last 10 years.
That is awful.
Uh-huh. And apparently my boss ran into a girl that he recognized from said cleaning service.
Okay.
At a Walmart, like a year or two ago.
Okay.
And, recognized her from this, office.
Mm-hmm.
And said, oh, hey, I recognize you. Yeah, I talked to Frank, the guy who runs the place. And apparently said girl panicked, got on her cell phone and immediately called somebody.
Yeah.
And then ran out of Walmart and jumped in a car that sped away.
Dude, she was probably human trafficked. Uh-huh. That is super fucked up.
Yep.
What? I feel like we should not be talking about this on a podcast. You should be talking about this to the authorities.
Sure, but nobody listens to this. And
I super don't feel good about this at all.
Again, this has been happening for well over 10 years.
The fact that it has been happening for 10 years does not make it right or legal.
It's true. And, you know, let's not think about the fact that this cleaning service has changed its name about 4 different times in the last 10 years.
Oh my god.
Yep.
Well, anyway.
So anyway, these are sweet girls who like to smoke. And they clean houses.
Okay. So Katya is in Niagara to meet a guy that she met on the internet.
Yeah, as they all do.
And is definitely not being catfished.
Ha! This was before catfishing was a thing?
Yeah. This is some early catfishing right here. Yeah. Yeah, like the people who decided to catfish saw this episode of Wonderfalls. Oh, wait, no, they didn't. It was never on TV.
They could have watched it on DVD.
Sure. And they're like, hey, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
12-year-old kid. I'm going to do that with my life.
But yeah.
So they... Eric basically takes pity on her.
Yes.
Because he sees himself in her.
Yeah.
And
she's a lost soul.
She is a lost soul. She's heartbroken.
Yeah.
Because
her to-be husband did not show up at the place where they were supposed to meet.
Right.
Yeah. And so yeah, so Eric takes pity on her and gives her some donuts.
Mm-hmm. Which he had originally brought for Jay.
Sure.
Scandalous.
Uh-huh.
Or at least hurtful.
Both.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't share your donuts with another woman.
No. Yeah, definitely not.
Bring them.
If they are intended for someone else.
Bring them to the only woman that they're meant for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, so they manage to... track down so they go to the chapel.
Yes.
where Katya is to be married, and while there Eric has a minor freak out about being in a place of weddings. It reminds him about his own failed marriage.
Sure.
And he passes out.
Yep.
Which Jay uses that as a distraction to steal the credit card and contact information for the person who booked the chapel for the wedding.
Yes.
Who has since canceled it.
So they recover Eric.
Mm-hmm.
They travel to the house of said person, Peter Johnson.
Yes.
Who turns out to be a 12-year-old kid.
Yeah. It's the kid from the movie The Kid. He's young Bruce Willis.
Okay. Is he?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, because are you familiar with that movie?
I am not.
So Bruce Willis, is, an adult.
Uh-huh.
And he is visited, I guess, or like his younger self manifests and lives with him and teaches him how to love life again.
All right.
And his younger self, the kid, the titular kid, is Peter Johnson from this episode.
Wow. That kid does not grow up to be Bruce Willis.
No, he did, well, as far as we know, yeah. I don't know.
I'm just looking at him.
Yeah.
He is not Bruce Willis material.
He could drop some weight,
I guess.
Who knows? He's a little chubby kid.
Yes, he is. He reminded me more of a kid from The Sandlot.
Yeah, I can see that.
Than any other movie.
Yeah,
yeah,
definitely.
He has been corresponding with Katya via email on the internet and has completely lied about himself. Because she was expecting a bigger Peter.
Yes. The preponderance of penis jokes in this episode is actually a delight.
Yeah.
It helps. I don't want to say elevate.
Definitely not that.
It improved.
Sure.
An otherwise somewhat lackluster episode.
I'll give you that. Penis jokes are always funny.
Yeah, they're not bad. Yeah.
Especially if you're idiots like us.
Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, Katya is understandably upset.
Yeah.
Peter is still trying to get her, basically.
Sure. Yeah.
I mean, the rest of the episode, because there's not a ton that really happens.
Not really.
But yeah, the rest of the episode is little Peter Johnson, alternately trying to get Katya to be with him because,
yes,
you know, he paid for her and he is a man.
Yep.
And therefore he owns her.
Sure.
Not a problem at all.
Nope.
And then, after Jay forcefully tells him to leave her alone, he becomes smitten with her.
Sure.
And presumably wants to own her and keep her locked up or something.
Well, you know, men deserve to own the women that they are infatuated with. For sure.
Sure. Sure, especially when you're 12.
Yep.
And a little shit.
Yep.
Because he is a little shit.
He is.
He's the worst.
He is pretty much the worst.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he at one point rams himself into a light post or something.
Yeah,
to give himself a black eye.
Yeah, he had like a 2x4 with a boxing glove on it that was attached to a light post, which he then rides into face first.
Yep,
to fake that he's been beaten up by Eric.
Yes.
Which I don't know how no one saw through that. Or is that what I meant to say? I don't know how anyone saw through that.
Yeah.
It's probably what I meant to say.
Sure.
It's November 9th, and I'm real tired.
I did not sleep well last night.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was not a good night for anybody.
Yeah.
Of our ilk.
Nope.
Yeah.
Or America.
Of our ilk.
Leave us a review on iTunes.
See you,
listeners.
Because apparently the majority of America is not of our ilk.
Right.
Good times.
Good times, great oldies. So yeah, it's shenanigans, basically.
Yeah.
With Peter trying to curry favor with Jay. Jay and Eric sort of sparring the whole episode about you know, their relationship, the nature of what
will
they're doing.
They won't they?
Exactly. It's oh, it hit you over the head. Will they? Won't they?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, they both expressed interest in each other prior to this.
Yes.
So you know, it's sort of figuring out the will they piece of it.
Yeah.
When are they going to pull the trigger on this thing? And Jay, Eric calling out Jay on her issues with intimacy and letting people close to her.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it gets a little tired.
Sure.
Because there's not a lot else going on in the episodes.
Yeah, not really. At one point, they find Peter's dad,
mm-hmm.
Dick Johnson.
Dick Johnson!
And confronts him about what is happening with Peter,
mm-hmm.
Who eventually finds Katya, and then they wind up fucking.
Yeah, Dick Johnson goes over to Jay's trailer, which is where Katya's been living.
Sure.
And, it was actually kind of nice.
Sure.
Dick Johnson, Peter's mother has died of cancer. And so they've both got some issues that they're working through as a result of that. But the letters, Dick Johnson finds that the letters that Peter has sent to Katya, with all the beautiful poetry, and imagery are just, copies of the letters that Dick sent to his wife before they were married.
Yes.
And so that's a little bit sweet.
Yeah.
Until Dick Johnson fucks Katya in Jay's trailer.
There's nothing wrong with some fucking.
I guess not. Yeah. But that resolves that whole thing.
Yep.
Literally.
Well, you know.
Like so Jay had asked Sharon to help with getting Katya sent back to Russia.
Yes.
But now apparently Katya does not need to do that because I don't know. Because
Dick Johnson knows how to fuck.
I guess.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. It's very just no. Really, really questionable material.
These are
in this episode.
All the solutions to all of our problems.
Uh huh.
Just fucking really good.
Just bone zone.
Yep.
Just giving her the old Dick Johnson.
Yep. This is how I plan on solving all of my problems.
That's not a good plan.
It's a perfectly
We've talked
fine.
About this. This is a terrible plan.
This is a perfectly fine plan.
I don't want to talk about
There's
this.
There's nothing wrong. Nothing bad that will come up. Co Dick Johnson.
Okay. So meanwhile, Harry Johnson. Sorry, Peter Johnson.
Yes.
There's no Harry Johnson. That's their cousin from Decatur. Peter Johnson. This headcanon. Peter Johnson has kidnapped Eric under the pretense that Jay is injured in his family's cabin out in the middle of the woods.
This is after Peter has stolen Jay's car.
Right. Right.
So they head to the family cabin, and as Eric walks into the cabin, Peter grabs a bat,
uh-huh.
that he is going to bludgeon Eric with.
Yeah.
Eric, of course, sees through all this.
Yeah, he's not a total idiot.
Not a total idiot. He's an idiot, for sure.
I mean, he's a block of wood.
Yeah, exactly.
But he at least has a brain.
Yes. Somewhat.
Somewhat, yeah.
So he was able to put a stop to all this, and then confronts Peter about what is happening.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Jay shows up in Eric's car, who drives a really fancy fucking car.
Yeah, I was very surprised by the. It's like a red sports car looking thing. Maybe a little older, but still, you know, a pretty decent car.
Fancier than someone like Eric should have.
Yeah, he is essentially homeless.
Yes.
Living in the back room of the barrel.
Yeah.
But he drives a really nice car.
Yep. He shouldn't be driving any car.
Probably not.
Yeah.
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 I was surprised to hear that he had a car.
Exactly.
In this episode.
I mean, I guess, you know, at some point he should probably have bought a car.
Yeah.
You know, since he has been living there for a while, but I'm pretty sure he did not bring a car.
Yeah.
To Niagara Falls after his wedding to his wife.
Yeah.
And whatever car he should have is definitely not like a Camaro or a whatever it was that he had.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, so Jay has hotwired this car and come out to the cabin, which she knows where it is.
Yeah, sure.
Somehow.
Yeah.
She susses out the location. I don't know.
Plots.
Plot, yeah. Wibbly wobbly. Plotty waddy. But yeah, so she comes out there to rescue Eric, who doesn't need to be rescued.
No.
He's just having a chat with Peter about feelings.
Yeah.
And Peter's dead mom. And Jay.
Yeah.
And so Peter sort of... Peter goes inside to get Jay a soda.
Yep.
And Jay and Eric have a chat, by which I mean Eric gives a speech about how damaged the two of them are and how that means they should definitely go on a date.
Yeah. I've been involved in similar speeches.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mostly just the damaged parts.
Yeah.
Not the actual date part.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm fucked up, you're fucked up is not a good reason for two people to go on a date initially.
Probably.
like maybe I guess I could see it later on in a relationship.
Probably.
But not to start. That's not a good...
What about,
I don't know.
What about in the middle?
I said, yeah, maybe later on.
Okay, all right.
Maybe. But it's still not great.
What about, like, post-breakup and then maybe a reconciliation?
No, that's a recipe for disaster.
Is it?
Yes.
Huh.
Yes.
I don't know. Degree to disagree.
Okay. All right.
I'm fucked.
Yeah. Maybe a little bit.
But not as fucked as we are in America.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, you're in America, so you're that fucked, too.
No, yeah. Yeah, things are great.
Yeah. And they're only getting better.
Oh, yeah. So Jay and Eric are having a discussion. And yeah, they wind up making out a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Because, nice. Sure, the logic of the situation is that, if we make out now, then there's no pressure, when they go on their date.
Yeah.
Yeah, which, in a way, makes a little bit of sense.
It does kind of make sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not great sense.
It's fine.
Yeah, it's about as good a sense as anything that's going on in my life.
It's Jay sense.
Yeah. And then Peter shows back up, and, Eric's car catches on fire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's the end.
Yeah, it is.
That is the end of the episode.
Absolutely it is.
And they all lived happily ever after.
Sure. I hope Eric had insurance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, if it wasn't a rental. She's from out of state.
That is true. Who would rent that nice of a car?
I don't know. Eric's pretty dumb.
That is also true.
Maybe Heidi set up the rental.
I mean, I know I've rented a car occasionally, and usually it is nicer than my own car.
Yeah.
But, you know, not sports car nice.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just like, oh, hey, maybe someday when I have to buy a new car, I should look and do something similar to this.
Exactly.
Not, I am going to be a demon on the highway.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he's going through a crisis.
Well, sure, aren't
for
we all?
Sure. Not a midlife crisis, but definitely some sort of a crisis.
Yeah.
So I guess it makes sense on that level,
sure.
But still, it was jarring.
Again, I've been through some crises.
Mm-hmm.
I believe you may have been as well.
Yeah.
Have you ever thought about just well, fuck it, I'm buying a Ferrari?
I have not.
Okay.
But I mean, you know, people deal with things in different ways.
I guess.
So,
I mean, I did buy $100. Batman comic by Clay Jones.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's as far as I usually go.
But that's awesome.
Yeah, it is. It truly
and
is.
A car is a car.
Yeah. It only gets you from place to place.
That's right.
Kelly Jones Batman comic will sit there on your shelf.
Hey, it'll last forever. Cars wear out.
That is also true. Can't deny that.
No. So this episode was fine.
Yeah. Again, hardly any animal interaction.
Yeah.
Sharon shows up. That is pretty much the extent of Jay's family that we've seen.
Mm-hmm.
Even Mahandra does not have that big of a role throughout the episode.
Yeah.
It is primarily all Eric, and Eric is boring.
Yeah. 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 Even Jay doesn't really have much to do in this episode.
Not really. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just to be lusted after.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is fair.
Well, sure, she's lustful.
Yeah. But, yeah.
Yeah.
It's complicated.
Yeah. Yeah, you know what? 8 episodes in, 1 bad episode, 1 not great episode.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Right?
I think that's fine.
Yeah. Hopefully the next one will be better.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
All right, we will, we'll be back then.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, goodbye.
Bye. Make America great again.
Shut up.
Thank you for listening to The Viewmasters. You can subscribe to the show directly at view.guttertrash.net or at iTunes and leave us a review. Visit view.guttertrash.net for email information and links to Facebook and Twitter. We'll see you next time on The Viewmasters.